The second trailer for Dragon Ball Super Broly dropped, and a lot of people are pissed. And honestly, I can kind of understand why. There were many, many unusual retcons in this trailer, one of which that gets brought up time and time again is what they've done to Bardock. But what they did to Bardock and Frieza and the final days of Planet Vegeta was actually already retconned by Toriyama in Dragon Ball Minus. So what I want to do with this video is explain to all of you what the major differences were between old Bardock and new Bardock. In other words, the portrayal of the Fall of the Saiyans that was given to us in the original manga written by Toriyama himself and in the Bardock TV special that inspired him to put that in the manga, and the newer version of the events in Dragon Ball Minus that are now being adapted into Dragon Ball Super Broly. And if you're wondering why people are so mad, this video will answer it, because they do have a point, and I'll let you know what that is next. It's October, and that means Halloween. And even if you don't celebrate the holiday, Verve has something for you. On the Shudder app, on the Verve Combo Pack, there are tons and tons of horror movies on Verve for you to watch when you get the service, including not just independent horror films, but also recent movies, well, kind of recent, like American Psycho's on here, some of the Halloween films are on here, and also classic Alfred Hitchcock films too, plus a lot of creepy TV shows and creepy series can be found on Verve. Check it out down below. Plus, there's a new update to Nick Splat with new episodes of Doug, Rocket Power, and tons of Nick shows, and of course, anime, tons of it as well. VRV.co/geekdom. Try it out for free. The link is down below. Those of you who have been following me for any length of time, you know that I really don't like talking about canon because of things like this. Because very often, things get changed in Dragon Ball. Sometimes by Toei and the anime staff, sometimes by Toyotaro, sometimes by Toriyama himself. And this is probably the most prevalent example of him making a major change that existed both in his original manga and in his more modern work. Specifically, we're talking about Dragon Ball Minus, which was written by Toriyama. So, let's go back to the original story of Bardock. Now, I made a video years ago, a Dragon Ball in-depth, talking about the history of the character of Bardock. And in that video, I explained that Bardock was not originally a Toriyama creation. Much like Broly, he was created by Takao Koyama for the anime TV special covering the history of the Saiyans called Bardock the Father of Goku in the English-speaking world. And that special aired on television during the run of the Frieza saga. Now, Toriyama watched that special and was so inspired by it and loved it so much that he actually incorporated Bardock into the manga. Bardock was the first character that was an anime-only creation that Toriyama loved so much that he put it in his own manga. But the way that Toriyama portrayed Bardock in the manga was clearly taken from the TV special, and I think a lot of Dragon Ball fans forget it and try to defend Toriyama by saying it's not a retcon of the manga, when what he's doing with Minus and with Broly is a retcon of the manga. So if you're watching this right now and you have your manga handy, open up your manga, head over to manga chapter 307, which is in the Frieza saga. In manga chapter 307, Vegeta mumbles the word Kakarot, and Frieza recognizes it as being a Saiyan name, looks at Goku, and remembers that this guy, Goku, Kakarot, looks just like the Saiyan that rebelled and opposed him at the very end when he destroyed Planet Vegeta. That was Goku's father, Bardock. And if you look at the way Toriyama drew him, he looks exactly like how he did in the TV special. Toriyama drew him with the original armor and with the bandana that signified the falling of Bardock's teammate. The fact that Bardock looks like this in the manga completely validates the TV special's events. And a lot of fans for many years thought that the TV special, even though it was anime only, was a part of Toriyama's continuity because Bardock is right there. The rebellion happened, he's dressed the way he is, and Frieza destroyed the planet along with Bardock at the exact same time. It's right there in that manga chapter. Just for reference, Toriyama published this manga on January 5th, 1991. Right? 22 years later, in 2013, Toriyama returned to draw Dragon Ball Minus, which is going to be his version of the Bardock event actually happening. The problem is that this version of the events not only contradicts the original anime TV special where Bardock was even created to begin with, but it contradicts his own manga that he himself wrote and illustrated back in 1991. In the Dragon Ball Minus version of the event, there is no rebellion. Bardock suspects that Frieza was doing bad. All of the events in the TV special with Bardock seeing the future and all that stuff, it was all cut out. And in this version of the event, Goku is actually 3 years old. He's not just a baby infant, which once again contradicts the manga, because the way that Roshi described Kakarot, baby Kakarot, Goku in the manga, was that he was a baby. It was never said he was a kid. He said he was a baby. So again, that's another retcon by Toriyama. And as much as I respect Toriyama, it's just, it creates a plot hole. You can't deny that. It's literally contradictory to what we're seeing in the original manga. So in Minus, not only is Goku 3 years old, but Bardock looks very different. He's got a different kind of Saiyan armor. He is obviously, the event with his friend dying and the bandana with blood on it, that never happened, even though we see the bandana in the original manga. There's major differences here. And that's not even including the fact that in this version, Bardock seems to be a much more sympathetic character and a much more loving father to Goku. And Goku appears to know who his parents are and be very sad and upset that he's going to Earth and saying goodbye to him. Whereas in the original story, Bardock was a much colder person and didn't really care about his son until he had those visions of the future, the fate of his own race and the fate of his own son, that he realized the importance of Goku in the story. He realized what Goku would go on to do. In Dragon Ball Minus, Frieza just destroys the planet and that's it. We don't see a rebellion. Now, we look at the Broly trailer. Take a close look at the Broly trailer. This is, once again, not what was in the original manga that Toriyama wrote. Frieza, first of all, looks very different. He's not wearing his traditional armor. The way it was portrayed in the manga, we see Frieza wearing his armor when he finally killed off the entire Saiyan race, or at least most of the race. In the Broly trailer, he's not wearing that armor at all. He's not wearing it. So it's visibly right there in the trailer. You see it right there on your screen. No armor. Also, look at this shot of Planet Vegeta and the giant ball heading towards it. There's no rebellion here. There's no Bardock. There's no other Frieza warriors. It's completely different. And in fact, this was kind of foreshadowed in Dragon Ball Super when we see a very brief flashback of Frieza blowing up the planet and there didn't appear to be anybody there. So this idea that Toriyama had of how Frieza destroyed the Saiyans is a huge contrast to what he told us in the manga and what the old TV special did. Because a lot of people like to say that, well, the anime's non-canon and the manga is. Fine, you can say that if you want to, but one problem that we're running into now is that Toriyama is retconning his own work. And that, you know, is, to me, a little bit annoying. I mean, some people are okay with it. That's fine if you like Dragon Ball Minus. That's not what this video is about, but it's clearly showing you that the original events that were played out in the original manga created by the same guy who's writing this Broly movie do not coincide with the original story. So if you're reading the manga and you're going to go see this Broly movie, you're getting two different versions of the same tragedy, but they're very, very different versions. And this cannot be ignored. I mean, there's a reason why people are mad, and that's why. Also, there has been a discussion about Vegeta possibly being de-aged, because in the trailer it states that Broly, Goku, and Vegeta were born around the same time. This completely contradicts what we have in the original series, and even in the guidebooks. Daizenshu 7 states that Vegeta was born in age 732, and that Kakarot was born in age 737, and age 737 is when the events of the fall of the Saiyans actually happened. Now, in Dragon Ball Minus, because Goku is 3 years old, that means that Goku would have been instead born in age 734, which only makes him about 2 years younger than Vegeta, as opposed to him being 5 years younger than Vegeta. And I guess that 2 years difference isn't really that crazy. Like, I feel like that's, it's understandable if you say they were born around the same time, because 2 years is not that much of a difference in time. But if the movie actually tries to tell us that Vegeta, Goku, and Broly were all born on the same day, and again, I'm not saying it will, but it might based on what this trailer is teasing, that is a complete change from what we were told, not just in the manga, in the anime, but also in the guidebooks. But the problem is the guidebooks themselves have been retconned, not just by Toriyama himself in interviews, but by things stated in Dragon Ball Super and in more recent material. So it just goes back to the whole purpose that I've said for a long time about not focusing too much on canon, because this guy Toriyama can change whatever the hell he wants whenever he wants, and people can't really do anything about it, to be honest with you. We can get mad and get upset if you want, and there's rightful reasons to be upset because this is a contradiction of the manga. This is not like multiple continuities like, you know, Dragon Ball Z, the anime, the games, Xenoverse, GT. You could at least separate those. This is Toriyama contradicting Toriyama. I'm still excited for the movie. I'm going to go see it. I'll probably have a good time, but it still is something that people are upset about. And once again, rightfully so, because it just changes things to an extreme degree. It's not even a small change. When Dragon Ball Minus first came out, a lot of Dragon Ball fans were very angry at the fact that Toriyama changed the story. But what happened was Dragon Ball Minus was largely ignored by people because it was a manga that was a bonus chapter at the end of Jocko, and most of the American fandom didn't even read the manga. That's why when you go see Resurrection F in theaters in the US, people didn't even know who the heck Jocko was, because manga's just not as big in this country as it is in Japan. That's a fact. So Dragon Ball Minus was largely just ignored. But now that they're taking this Dragon Ball Minus retcon and putting it into the Broly movie, people are angry all over again because it reminds them of just how irritating it was that Toriyama's retconning his own story, and it also solidifies it to the American audience because more people are going to go see the Broly movie internationally than they read the Dragon Ball Minus manga chapter. So this is going to confuse a whole new set of fans, and it's going to be pretty crazy going forward. So that's really where like the irritation and annoyance comes from the fandom. It actually does make sense. We thought that Minus was annoying, but whatever, it's its own little thing, we can ignore it. But now it's pretty hard to ignore because Toriyama's making changes to his original story, and unfortunately that's just how it is. But hey, the movie will probably be a lot of fun to watch either way. That's it. Thanks for watching. Hope you have a great day. And if you like this video and want to learn more about the history of these characters, check out these videos right now.